This is the timeline old Biff goes to when he goes back to 1955. At this point in the story, Marty has interfered with his parents' meeting but has not fixed it yet because the dance hasn't happened. We know at least three possible future outcomes at this point in the timeline. 1. Marty is never born because it's after he interferes with his parents falling in love and it's before he fixes it at the dance. 2. Marty succeeds at the dance, his parents fall in love, and he's born to cool parents instead of nerdy parents. 3. Young Biff uses a sports almanac from 2015 on his 21st birthday and becomes one of the richest men in the world.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Biff Tannen Museum.
Or it could be a combination of any of the three, because we know that in the Biff Pleasure Palace timeline, Marty's parents still fall in love.
Brian, do you know how much perfectly good dough I've blown on this no good kid of yours, huh?
So we know that even though Biff is given the almanac at this point in the story, it doesn't change the outcome at the dance. Later, we indeed see Biff get decked by George with the almanac in his pocket. At the time young Biff is given the book, Marty's family members are disappearing from his family photo. So it is unknown if Marty will succeed at the dance or not, so the future is not written yet. Like any other timeline, there is an infinite number of possible futures that could occur. Just because we know three of those possible futures does not make either future certain. For example, take possible future number 1. Marty will surely not exist if his parents never fall in love and get married. At this point in time, that future is unfolding, as evidenced by the vanishing family members in his photo. And even though Marty has interfered with his parents falling in love, a future where Marty no longer exists is not written or inevitable, not as long as something can occur to cause Marty's parents to fall in love. As long as Marty is still in 1955 working to get his parents together at the dance, he has therefore the means at his disposal to create a future where his parents fall in love, and he has the intent to create such a future, but that does not make that future inevitable. Marty has implemented a plan to get his parents together at this point in time, as evidenced by Lorraine purchasing her dress that she will wear at the dance. And even though the events that lead to Marty's parents falling in love have already been set in motion, a plan for a future does not a future make. And until George McFly actually decks Biff at the dance, a future where Marty's parents fall in love and he is born is not certain. Which is why, even after the events occur that lead up to his parents falling in love, Marty's existence is still not certain, and people in his photo keep disappearing, including himself, until his parents actually kiss and fall in love. In the same way, old Biff had a plan for a future where he's rich. He went back in time and brought with him the means to make that future a reality and thus to change his past. Yet, just as Marty's desired future that his parents fall in love was not certain until his parents kiss and begin to fall in love, in the same way the future old Biff desired to create was not certain until the events that created the future actually occur, namely young Biff uses the book and places bets and wins. You cannot proceed into the future of a timeline that does not exist yet, since old Biff gave his younger self the almanac and then headed back to the future before young Biff made bets with the almanac. He would not go to the Pleasure Palace future, for it had not yet been created. One might argue that if that were true, then when Marty and Doc went back to 1955 to stop young Biff from creating the Biff timeline, if they had proceeded to 1985 from this point in time, they would have gone to a future where Marty was never born. Which would mean that old Biff would also have returned to a 2015 where Marty was never born, instead of the 2015 that he came from. And this seems to make sense if you ignore certain realities. First of all, you have to ignore rule number two of time travel. Rule number one is, the future is not written yet. Rule number two, the future is not written, but the past is. And if you just came from the future is now the past.
The whole thing is my fault if I hadn't bought that damn book. None of this would ever happen.
No, that's all in the past.
You mean the future?
Whatever!
The future of 2015 where Marty is born to cool parents and where Doc travels time to 2015 with Marty and Jennifer is past to old Biff and to Doc and to Marty. Their very existence there in 1955 means that the future from whence they came is written because it's in the past.
Oh, this is heavy, Doc. I mean, it's like I was just here yesterday.
You were here yesterday, Marty. You were. Amazing, isn't it?
And although young Biff, who now received the book, will proceed into a different future that is yet unwritten, Doc, Marty, and old Biff would go to their futures should they jump back to the future, for their future is also their past, and it is written. Once old Biff gives young Biff the almanac, he creates an alternate reality. Since old Biff, Doc, and Marty are not of that reality, they will return to the future of their own reality. This is easily proved by looking at the moment in time when old Biff gives young Biff the almanac. Young Biff is no longer the same Biff as old Biff, because young Biff was given a sports almanac from 2015 when he was 18, and old Biff was never given a sports almanac. In fact, old Biff is a Biff who was decked by George McFly at the dance.
And I was just starting on the second coat.
And young Biff, who receives the almanac, was never decked by George McFly and actually grew up as George's supervisor.
Don't be so gullible, McFly.
They are not the same Biff. Their futures are completely different. They are from different realities. Should old Biff, Biff 2, travel to 2015 from that point, he would not return to Biff 1's future reality. Any more than young Biff, Biff 1, would return to Biff 2's reality should he travel forward in time from that point. The only way old Biff could get to young Biff's new reality is if old Biff waits until young Biff creates that reality 1 second after young Biff begins using the almanac, and then proceeds to the future from that point. Their continued existence in 2015 after old Biff goes back in time and gives out the book is all the evidence we need that their past timeline is still intact after old Biff gives young Biff the book. So when Doc and Marty travel back from their 2015 to 1985, they would not go to the new Biff Pleasure Palace reality in 1985. That timeline did not exist in their reality, otherwise they would not exist. They couldn't go to the Biff Pleasure Palace reality any more than someone who left 2015 in the Biff Pleasure Palace reality would go to the 1985 reality that Doc and Marty came from. It just wouldn't happen. So in reality, once Doc and Marty made it back to 1955, to the point in time where old Biff gives young Biff the almanac, they could have simply followed old Biff back to the 2015 they came from. And they could have set their time dial to arrive early enough in that 2015 to prevent old Biff from stealing the time machine.